Hello friends, subscribe to our channel GDC and press the bell icon for more updates.
Hello friends, here I am going to give a very basic mnemonic to remember the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. This is a very complicated classification, so by my tricks you maybe have some help so that you can easily remember the NSAIDs classification. As we know, all the NSAIDs act mainly in the FOX enzyme. FOX means cyclooxygenase enzyme. FOX enzyme are basically two types, FOX1 and FOX2. FOX1 enzyme is the called as housekeeping. Housekeeping, while FOX2 enzyme is the inducible enzyme. Inducible enzyme, that means mainly FOX1 enzyme is all time present in our body, that is secreted from the kidney, plasma, liver, all the parts that serve as housekeeping part. While FOX2 enzyme is inducible enzyme, and FOX2 enzyme only release after the inflammation. That means if any inflammation occurs, then FOX2 enzyme releases. And this FOX2 is mainly responsible for the antipyretic, analgesic and anti-inflammatory action. So our all the basically NSAIDs act in the FOX1 as well as mainly FOX2, but some also act in the FOX1. So we will here discuss the classification of NSAIDs. NSAIDs basically classified into the four classes. And the first class is non-selective FOX inhibitor. Non-selective FOX inhibitor, as its name indicates, non-selective. That means it inhibits FOX1 as well as FOX2. Non-selective FOX inhibitor have various subclasses. So how you will remember the various subclasses? Remember one word. IBS. IBS. Our papa. IBS. Our papa. These are the mnemonics by which you will remember all the subclasses of non-selective FOX inhibitor. How? Let me show you here. I for first subclass is indole derivative. Indole derivative. P, second subclass. P for propionic acid derivative. S, third subclass. S for salicylic acid derivative. Salicylic acid derivative. Next, O. Fourth subclass, O for oxycam derivative. Next, P. P for next subclass, pyrrole derivative. Pyrrole derivative. Next, A. Next subclass, A for anthranilic acid derivative. Next, again P, means next subclass, again P is pyrazolone derivative. and the last subclass and A for aryl acetic acid, aryl acetic acid derivative. So by this mnemonic you will remember all the subclasses of the non-selective COX inhibitor. Now the drug of this class, by the first name you will easily identify the drug. That means first subclass is indole derivative. Indole, here is the indomer. That means the drug is indomethacin, as well as there is also another drug, sulindac. Next, propionic acid derivative. Here remember the pro, that is ketoprofen, that have the pro. Next, ibuprofen, it also have pro. Next, salicylic acid derivative. Salicylic acid derivative, as its name indicate, salicylate. Salicylate is our aspirin. And the chemical name of aspirin is acetyl salicylic acid. Next, oxycam derivative. Oxycam derivative is piroxicam. Next, pyrrolopyrrole derivative. And the drug is ketorolac. Next, anthranilic acid derivative. And the anthranilic acid derivative is methanamic acid. Next, pyrazolone derivative. And your pyrazolone derivative is phenyl butazone as well as oxyphenbutazone. Phenyl butazone and oxyphenbutazone. And your last subclass is aryl acetic acid derivative. And the aryl acetic acid derivative is diclofenac. Diclofenac, aciclofenac. So these are the subclasses of non-selective COX inhibitor, and it is the first class of the NSAIDs. That means non-steroidal anti-inflammatory. Now your next class is preferential COX 2 inhibitor. This is not the non-selective. This is preferential COX 2 inhibitor. Means these drugs mainly act in the COX 2, but some action is also in the COX 1 also. So the drug of the preferential COX 2 inhibitor is ribosylide. Levobitone. The next class of the NSAIDs is selective COX 2 inhibitor. Selective COX 2 inhibitor only act in the COX 2 enzyme. So drug of the selective COX 2 inhibitor, all the drug name COXIN, like celecoxib, rafecoxib. So these have the COXIN in their name, and that is the identification that these drug are the selective COX 2 inhibitor. Now your next class of the NSAIDs, fourth class, is the analgesic, antipyretic with poor anti-inflammatory action. Means these drugs basically have analgesic action and antipyretic action, but anti-inflammatory action is very poor. And the drug of this class, you will remember simple word thing. Paracetamol not properly metabolized. Paracetamol not properly metabolized, and the drug of this class, first drug is as such, paracetamol. Not is nifopam. Next, P properly, that is propifen. Is propiphenazole and metabolized M for metmizole. Means paracetamol, nifopam, propiphenazole and metmizole, these drugs have analgesic and antipyretic action with very poor anti-inflammatory action. By this mnemonic, you will easily remember all the drug of the desserts. Thank you.